The sixth lesson teaches you the power of beliefs. Now, these beliefs can be either true or false, but if you believe them, you'll act that part. Beliefs become habits, and habits are nothing more than self-hypnosis, just like you learn to brush your teeth. The important aspect of the sixth lesson is that you learn to dehypnotize yourself from negative beliefs as Anna did. You learn to live happily and successfully. There are 3 8-hour periods to a day. 8 hours for work, 8 hours for relaxation, and 8 hours for sleep. And those 8-hour periods, those middle 8-hour periods are very vital to you. You are a king or a queen during those 8 hours. Who asks you to bring the troubles of your office into your home? Who asks you to bring the troubles of your home into your office? During those middle 8-hour periods, you learn to improve your self-image by concentrating on your success, and you make your image grow as tall as you want it to be. Which brings us to the seventh lesson, the quest for happiness. Believe it or not, happiness is a habit.
You mean unhappiness is a habit too?
It's just as much a habit as happiness, and it's just as easy to be happy as unhappy. You must learn that happiness belongs to you, like your eyes, like your heart, like your pulse. You reach for it. But when you reach for it, you must remember that you must not step on other people's toes. And what's equally important, you must not step on your own toes with negative feelings. Regardless of your age, regardless of your calling, regardless of your training, experience, or education, one thing common to every human being is the desire to be happy. The eighth lesson or step in creative psycho-cybernetics teaches you the various phases of the success mechanism, which will make your image grow as tall as you want it to be. S-U-C-C-E-S-S. That spells success. S, a sense of direction, your goal. U, understanding, where you understand your needs and the needs of other people. C, courage. C, compassion. E, esteem, self-respect. S, self-acceptance, that you are somebody, even though you've made a mistake, you rise above it. And finally, S, self-confidence. These are the seven aspects of success that'll make your image grow as tall as you want it to be. The ninth lesson in creative psycho-cybernetics teaches you about the failure mechanism which scars your self-image, and you learn about it only to realize the enemy within you in order to avoid it. F-A-I-L-U-R-E, which spells failure. F, frustration, which brings A, aggressiveness of the wrong kind, which brings I, insecurity, which brings L, loneliness, the great scourge of mankind, which brings U, uncertainty, which brings R, resentment, which brings E, emptiness, which makes you walk away from life, from reality. You remember F-A-I-L-U-R-E in order to avoid it and concentrate on the success mechanism within you. The 10th lesson in creative psycho-cybernetics teaches you how to be your own plastic surgeon, where you learn to remove the emotional scar within you that you put there yourself. You learn to be your own plastic surgeon by remembering to be too big to be threatened, by remembering to be self-reliant, and by remembering to relax. The 11th lesson in creative psycho-cybernetics teaches you how to stand up under stress, how to change a crisis into an opportunity.
You mean, Doctor, by positively approaching a stress, one can overcome this stress?
Yes, by not only positively thinking about it, but doing something creatively about it. You learn how to stand up under stress when you learn to practice without pressure, like money players in sports. You tackle a problem realistically by exercising your survival mechanism, your success mechanism within you that will steer your mind to a productive goal. The 12th and final lesson of creative psycho-cybernetics teaches you that you can be a winner just as easily as you can be a loser. You can change your luck deliberately. How? By simply concentrating on these two important points. One, you refuse, absolutely refuse, to let your negative feelings like frustration make your image shrink and shrink and shrink to the size of a microbe. You concentrate on your confidences of the past and use it continually in the present undertaking until it becomes second nature to you. You can use it whenever you want to, and it's like instant confidence. You become a winner when you learn to be yourself by understanding your rights, that you came into this world to succeed and not to fail, by selecting realistic goals to reach fulfillment, by exercising your creative success mechanism to achieve these goals. Now, these are the 12 fundamental points in creative psycho-cybernetics that will teach you to reach self-fulfillment as a human being, to be successful and happy.
Dr. Maltz has been lecturing before many audiences throughout the United States. And during his tenure of time, many questions have been asked. A list of those most frequently asked has been compiled.
Can you tell me how we can be ourselves?
Yes. Regardless of age or career, whether you're a student or a teacher, a doctor or nurse, a lawyer or secretary, a salesman or a manager, the important thing to realize is that you can't be a friend to others unless you're a friend to yourself first. You can't be a success with others unless you're a success with yourself first. You can't have the love of other people unless you have the love of yourself first. Even though you've made a blunder, you must learn to rise above it. It means hard work, but it's the greatest adventure in your whole life, something worth fighting for. You program yourself for countless goals, and when you reach one goal, the business of creative living is to reach for another.
How does this differ from positive thinking?
That's a very good question. Now, positive thinking says what it means. Think positively. Now, creative psycho-cybernetics means more than thinking. You think creatively, but you change that thought into a creative performance. In other words, psycho-cybernetics means doing. When? Now.
Is this a form of psychoanalysis?
No, it isn't, but it goes further than that. Psychoanalysis delves into the past, which is perfectly all right. But what is vital is that, suppose you know about the past, what are you going to do about your life now, N-O-W? And creative psycho-cybernetics means living creatively now, regardless of what the past is.